Let's talk about Excel's new and improved XLOOKUP function. You may have heard that XLOOKUP is Excel's new and fantastic lookup function that can replace index match, VLOOKUP, HLOOKUP, and more. My recommendation for all is to stop using VLOOKUP immediately. XLOOKUP is easier, faster, more powerful, and more user-friendly. Today, I will show you the syntax of XLOOKUP function and take you through three examples that will help you take advantage of the new XLOOKUP function. First, we'll talk about function syntax, explain what is what, and we will have first example to see how to work with XLOOKUP straight away. Second example is looking for partial match. Third example will be horizontal lookup. This will be example of HLOOKUP replacement. I hope you are looking forward to learning more, so don't forget to subscribe for future content and like this video. Now, let's get right into it. The XLOOKUP function searches a range of an array and then returns the items corresponding to first match it finds. If no match exists, the XLOOKUP can return the closest approximate match. The syntax goes as follows, and you can see it on the screen. And let's see what each of these arguments actually mean. First one we have is lookup value. This is a required argument, and this is the value we are searching for. The second one, lookup array, is also a required argument, and this is the array or range to search. The third one is return array, and this is also a required argument, and it is the range from which we will return the search. The fourth one, if not found, is optional argument. It is used where a valid match is not found, and then it can return, for example, text you supply. If a valid match is not found and this argument is missing, then you will have return of NA as a result. The next one, match mode, is optional argument as well. It is used to specify the match type. You can have exact match. If none found, then it will return NA, and this is a default setting. The next one is exact match. If none found, then the function will return the next smaller item. The next one is similar, exact match, and if none found, then it will return the next larger item. And the last is a wildcard match, where asterisk, question mark, and tilde, which have their specific meanings. Last argument we have is search mode. Specifically, the search mode can be used to either perform a search first to last or last to first, perform a binary research that relies on lookup array being sorted in ascending order. If not sorted, invalid results will be returned. And lastly, perform a binary search that relies on lookup array being sorted in descending order. And if it is also not sorted, invalid results will be returned. Now that we covered the syntax and what is what in it, how can you use this syntax in one simple example? Let's try to get employee name based on ID number. So here we have employee IDs and employee names. I'll just pick one of these, which we will use for search, and look for the name that's associated. So the first thing we need to do is select the lookup value argument. Then we are looking at lookup array, followed by return array. And you can press enter and you will get Erlene Arnold. And now let's try doing it the other way around. Let's take the name and look for ID number. So I copy pasted the name, and here we are going to do a function. Again, let's select the lookup value. Now the lookup array is names, and return is from employee IDs, and press enter. If you ever use the VLOOKUP, you immediately notice that you could go left in your search criteria, and that's a big advantage over VLOOKUP. The second example for XLOOKUP is for partial match. Let's try to find what is the employee's name based on the last name search. So I picked Erlene Arnold's last name for this example as well. Let's start with our formula. XLOOKUP, and now we need to write the asterisk, wildcard, because wildcard character is considered a text, we need to place this wildcard asterisk sign in quotation mark and connect it with the cell's last name. Then look for a lookup array and have a return array. In our case, it is going to be the same. And now instinctively, you could press enter and you get the error message. So what else do we need to add in this case? Let's put more arguments. The first one, if not found, let's try it. Name not found in quotation marks. And this one is important. Now here we need to specify our match mode. And since we are using the wildcard search, we need to write number 2. Remember, I said that the exact match is the default. This is why we received an error earlier. Close the parentheses, and we get Erlene's full name. Erlene's full name written here. Third example will be horizontal lookup. And this is example of HLOOKUP replacement. What do you do if the table we receive is horizontal? In this case, we need to do a horizontal lookup instead of vertical lookup. And that is very easy to do with XLOOKUP function. So let's first pick one name and look what's the employee's ID number by writing the XLOOKUP function. Selecting our lookup value, and then selecting the lookup array, that's the names, and return array, that's the IDs, and press enter. Let me know down in comments if you will be using XLOOKUP in your work. If you like this video, give the video a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to the channel to improve your skills in the future. See you in the next one.